नमामि गंगे तव पाद पंकजं सुरासुरैर्वन्दितो दिव्यरूपं भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासि नित्यं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानां गङ्गातरङ्गरमणीयजटाकलापं गौरीनिरन्तरविभूषि त्वामभागम् नारायण प्रियमनङ्गमदापहारं वरानसिपुरपति भजवीशनाथं वागीशजुष्वदने लक्ष्मीर्यश्व च वक्षसि यस्यास्ति हृदय संविधिः त्वं नृसिंहमहं भजे हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे भिद्यते हृदयग्रन्थि छिद्यन्ते सर्वसंशय क्षीयन्ते चास्य कर्माणि दृष्टनेवात्मनीश्वरे भिद्यते हृदयग्रन्थि छिद्यन्ते सर्वसंशय क्षीयन्ते चास्य कर्माणि दृष्टनेवात्मनीश्वरे गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति श्री शिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद टोल्ड It is our duty to serve Sadguru, pure Vaishnava, who is busy with the seva of Supreme Lord all the 24 hours. We should serve that kind of Paramahansa Guru Vaishnava by the help of that pure Guru Vaishnava. We can realize everything. We can realize everything what is what. Guru and Bhagavan both adhakshaja vastu. Don't misunderstand that Guru is a man and Bhagavan is adhakshaja vastu. Don't think that way. Guru, Prabhupada speaking, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada speaking, Guru and Bhagavan both, they are adhakshaja vastu. Many times before I explained what is adhakshaja vastu, what is akshaja vastu. As per the definition of Jiva Goswami Pada, I told adhakrita akshaja jnanam tatha indriyaja jnanam jena iti adhakshajam. Adhakshaja is such object, absolute object, where Maya cannot reach, our personal effort, all our money power, manpower, or anything, educational power, nothing can reach. So Jiva Goswami was writing definition, adhakrita, akshaja jnanam, absolute personality going to throw our personal effort down. His name is adhakshaja vastu. Our personal effort cannot reach up to that point. That's why Jiva Goswami was speaking adhakrita akshaja jnanam. All our material efforts are being kicked by the Supreme Lord. Down, go. Yato vacho nivartante aprapa manasasaho. You can remember many times I told. Bhagavan is predominating absolute, and Radharani is predominated absolute. Absolute person, personality, Supreme Lord, has a nice all proper adjustment with Guru Padma. No disparity, totally. dovetailed. Prabhupada used to watch this. Khape khape in Hindi and Bengali. Gurudeva Tatma, you have to look. If there is any mistake in Guru Darshan, total bhajan can spoil. Guru Sevak Bhagwan, today morning time I also seeking. In Vrindavan, sometimes in some different sampradaya mandir, they are speaking, Jai Gurudev Bhagwan ki jai ho. Somebody complained to me, Maharaj, it is wrong. It is wrong they are speaking this way, Gurudev Bhagwan ki jai ho. I say, no, it is not wrong actually. Their jaikara is not wrong. They are speaking this way, it is wrong. Maybe their conception is wrong. I don't know, they are Mayavadi, maybe other sampradaya. When they are speaking Gurudev Bhagwan ki joy, we are not speaking in our Gauriya Math. Because all other people can be in confusion. So I don't speak. Well, it is not wrong Siddhanta. Wrong Siddhanta, not wrong Siddhanta. Gurudev is also Bhagwan. Asraya Vigraha. Gurudev is Bhagwan at the same time devotee. At a time. Gurudev is not Bhagwan. Gurudev is Bhagwan. I mean, when Bhagwan Sri Krishna speaking to Uddhava, that know me, know it for sure that I am Guru. Know it for sure that I am Guru. Follow, Bhagwan speaking. Know it for sure that I am Guru. So, Gurudev, at the same time, he is Bhagavan, Sevak Bhagavan, at the same time, he is Bhakta. He went to show us how to do devotional practice of Acharya Mam Bijaniyat. Bhagavan himself speaking to Uddha. Acharya Mam Bijaniyat. Bijaniyat. Niyat means affirmative. Bijaniyat means affirmative, know it for sure, 100%. Acharya Mam Bijaniyat, know myself as Acharya. I am coming in the form of Acharya. So, a Sevak Bhagavan. So, Guru at the same time, Bhagavan and Bhakta going to show us the procedure, how to do bhajan this day, to save us from aparadha, different kind of fault, going to rectify. And Shakshad Haritana Samasya Sasya Ruktos Tata Bhavvata Evasya. He is Bhagavan at the same time, he is dear and near one of Bhagavan. Guru Purna Shakti and Krishna is Purna Shaktiman. Try to understand. Don't be in confusion. Prabhupada speaking, somebody putting question to Prabhupada. Prabhupada, we can think our Gurudev is Radharani? Can we think that way? Prabhupada said, yes, if we go up and up and look very carefully, analytically we can see, yes, Gurudev is Radharani. Of course in Madhura's bhajan, this right. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada speaking, whenever I look at the lotus feet of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I can see the total manifestation of Radharani inside him. What to speak? Our darshan is very dirty darshan, ugly darshan. We will have to pray continuously unto the lotus feet Sudarshan Chakra will to rectify our darshan day and night. Oh Sudarshan, please. Rectify our darshan. Our darshan is so ugly darshan, dirty darshan. We cannot go ahead in our bhajan. So impediment, so barrier. Always we misunderstand. Our darshan is so ugly, cannot. So Gurudev, Radharani coming in the form of Gurudev. So naturally, Radharani is Purna Shakti. I was explaining that the word Purna. Material conception prevailing everywhere. Material conception prevailing everywhere. So nobody have proper conception. In eternal world, Purna means is really Purna. And the conception of Purna in this material world is defective. From Purna, suppose you put a bucket of milk. If I take one glass of milk, then you can discover deficiency. But in transcendental world, there is no such case. Purna shapurna madhaya purna mev avashishvati. So counterpart of Krishna is also complete. So counterpart of Krishna is not possible. Follow? Counterpart. And a counterpart of Purna Vastu is also Purna. Counterpart of Purna Vastu is Purna. Counterpart not possible. If at all you think the counterpart is also Purna. Because Purna, from infinity, minus infinity is infinity. Infinity plus infinity is infinity. This conception you should, this kind of defective conception, this kind of incomplete conception is not applicable in transcendental world. So Gurudev is Purna Shakti. I cannot try to find any fault with Gurudev. Oh, my Gurudev don't know English. My Gurudev have no idea about mathematics, physics, chemistry. Sanskrit also my Guru Maharaj not knowing. This kind of conception is like stool and urine. We should not have. Gurudev is Purna. It is there, but I cannot see. This is right darshan. Gaurakishore Babaji having no knowledge about mathematics, English is wrong darshan. Because Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj have full knowledge about Krishna. Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj going to love Krishna. So, we cannot say this way. So, from Upanishad we know this sloka, we know that Purnasya Purna Madhaya Purna Meva Vashishate. Again, another sloka from Upanishad, Jasmin Gatte Sarvamidam Vigyatam Bhavati. After knowing Krishna, there is nothing incomplete in my knowledge bank. If I know Krishna out of love, not out of false ego, if Krishna allow me to know himself, like in the Chatushloki Bhagavatam, you know, Jnanam Paramam Gujhyami Yad Vijnana Samannitam Sarahasam Tadanganja Jnana Guditam Maya Javanaham Yatha Bhavu Yad Rupa Guna Karmakaha Tathaiva Tattva Vijnanam Astu Te Madanugrah. By the mercy of Bhagavan, if I can know, even Krishna cannot know himself completely. So I cannot say I know Krishna completely. I am just speaking. If you can know Krishna, then you are knowing everything. No shortage of knowledge, no shortage of mathematics, English, nothing. Because all knowledge, directly or indirectly coming from Sambhit Shakti. Follow? All knowledge, everything, material knowledge or transcendental or anything coming from that. So we cannot have any wrong conception in it. Now, Prabhupada speaking, who is serving Krishna all the 24 hours? That is Sadguru, and I must serve him. I cannot submit unto the lotus feet of a cheater guru. I must submit unto the lotus feet of such a guru who can arrange 100% benefit, mangal for me. Not 99%, 100% can give me mangal. If I am sure, then. And Prabhupada speaking, somebody going to serve Gurudev, but they are going to hate Guru Vaishnava as some Vaishnavas. This is totally wrong conception of Guru Tattva. If some Acharya going to speak about Harikatha, everything, and going to prove, I am the only Acharya all over the world, and all my Gadbhas, everything, all useless, they are rascal, then surely he is a branded Avaishnava. The more you do transcendental seva, the more you can develop trinadapi. The more you can do transcendental seva, prakita seva, the more you can develop trinadapi bhava. Without which, all your preaching, all your japa, tapa, whatever you are doing, all useless. Has got no meaning. People foolish, they can do, they can run like, you know, like a blind man. A blind man guided by another blind and blind. Andha yathandi rupaniya manam teopi sechatanta marudam nivadya. One blind man can never be guided by another. Both of them cannot see. There is a condition. All foolish. They are less interested to get complete idea about absolute truth. Some glamour, some position, some rank, some pratishtha. Okay. This is called Hari Bhajan. This is their conception. So with Guru, I will have to serve pure Guru Vaishnava. Those who are in line with my Gurudev. If I hate, then surely I am going to fall down. So Jiva Goswami writing in Sandarbha, Guru Bhagaya, Tat Sevan Avirodhena Cha, Annesamupi Vaishnavanam Sevanam Sreya. Jiva Goswami writing in Sandarbha, with Gurudev, with the consent, with the permission of Gurudev, without disturbing the main Guru Seva. This is also Guru Seva, to serve Vaishnava. Without disturbing the main Guru Seva, after taking permission from Gurudev, if I can serve pure Guru Vaishnava, is very helpful for my bhajan. You don't know. You, it is my not, it is this Vaishnava from outside and not in my society. Foolish. You also like to think like foolish. Vaishnava can never be confined within the conception of, you know, caste and creed, this, that, country. He is American, he is an Italian. Foolish conception. Guru Vaishnava can never be confined with this narrow conception. They are open to all. Even outside people can get kippa from Indian sadhu. What wrong in it? What kind of wrong conception we have? Whereas we know, even international scientists, international doctors, maybe they are from any country, but still, when we see their international quality they have, any poet, any writer, any scientist, any doctor, we cannot confine them. We cannot say, he is Indian. His service is for all whole human beings. Follow what I say. This kind of narrow conception cannot allow you to get entry into Bhagavad Bhajan. So be careful. Prabhupada speaking in the name of Guru Vaishnava Seva, if you are going to serve a non-devotee who is in the guise of devotee, Prabhupada speaking, then big problem. You cannot get any benefit, at the same time you can get a feedback. You can go back to your bhajan. You cannot make it. In the name of devotee, if I am going to serve any non-devotee, who is a totally non-devotee, his activities, his character, all his greed for money, position, but idiot people cannot understand. It's so foolish. Prabhupada speaking, I can discuss tomorrow, that in this material world, people, they are so foolish. They are not going to give value to any pure Vaishnava. They don't understand kapat. This material world is full of kapat bhav. Prabhupada speaking. This material world is full of kapat bhav. Nobody out of kapat bhav. Someday I can discuss Jagadananda Pembivarta before Gaur Purnima. Totally. To expose the naked truth in front of you all. I know this book, people can, it is basic book, you throw it. But I think it is the topmost book. If you don't know, never you can do bhajan. You cannot even understand what is bhajan. So I can take risks to discuss. Risks mean so many tough things are there, Siddhanta Vichara. If you don't go through this book, Jagadananda Pembivarta, your bhajan life is useless. As a Gauriya bhajan, Gauriya devotee, you must know it. So I can try by your mercy. Prabhupada speaking, this whole world is full of kapat bhava. Those who are not going to misguide you, that kind of sadhu not going to get any honor. Those who are not going to misguide you, that kind of sadhu at present not going to get any honor in this society. This kind of situation. People not going to stop thinking that we are doing so much satsanga, why we are not making? Actually, you are not doing satsanga. At all, if you are doing satsanga, if you are 100% sure, then 100% benefit is certified. As per different shastra, even Narad Bhakti Sutra, Sandilya Bhakti Sutra, if I read in front of you, you can understand. Sadhu Sangha is so powerful. Yesterday I was discussing, na? Bahavo mat padam prapta trashtakaya dhavadayuhu visabarva balirvana mayas chata vivishana. I already told. They all going to get the lotus feet of Krishna only and only by the help of Sadhu Sangha. You forget it. You forget it, I know. And in Bhakti Sutra, Narad Bhakti Sutra, Shandila Bhakti Sutra, you can get so many sutra like formula, like mathematics formula. It is written, Narad Bhakti Sutra, Mahat Sangastu Durlabo Agamyo Amaghascha. If I explain, you can go mad, but I cannot give enough time. Mahat Sangastu Kintu. Be careful. Mahat Sangha is so rare, so rare, so rare that it is impossible, almost impossible to get. And if you get, by chance if you get, it infallible. Definitely you can get result. Avarsila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Avarsila Sachidananda Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. Oh man, after traveling many different continents, many countries, many villages, many cities, very rare, by chance, you can meet with one pure sadhu who has no self-interest. Even after that, you can understand or cannot understand, because Vidurji Maharaj is so dirty, cloth and everything, who is a beggar? It's not sadhu. Sadhu means very glamorous car is there, all people can go behind, oh Maharaj ki jai ho, and he can fly in different country, have big amount of, money, everything. Oh, he is sadhu. Who is sadhu? Gaur Kisipa sadhu? Useless. Foolish people. They have no conception. Many time I am shouting like dog, please try to disclose this secret thing, this Guru Tattva, Vaishnava Tattva. You need not fight with anybody. You just share this Harikatha with all people. Then by chance they hear, they can understand, oh, this is Guru Tattva. So long I am blind, I couldn't realize. Yes. If your Guru Darshan, Vaishnava Darshan is rectified, okay, then no problem. Your car, your bhajan car can go ahead very smoothly. This is the main thing all over the world. You will have to circulate all over the world. All over the world you will have to circulate this Guru Tattva, Vaishnava Tattva. Only the thing, if you like to satisfy Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur, I promise you, you will have to do. You have to do this thing, take trouble. Only this way. You need not fight with anybody regarding Raganuga Bhajan Rupa. Don't do it. Simply, you try to share all this Guru Tattva and Vaishnava Tattva, then people can automatically get rectified if their luck is good. If they are unlucky, still after staying with Prabhupada, so many devotees gone away, throwing Prabhupada. Even they are not going to identify Prabhupada is my guru. They accept another guru. This case happens so many. It's quite natural. Bhaktajeev is tatastha. If find comfortable with Gurudev, they find okay, Gurudev is very good. If he find not comfortable, they can throw Gurudev and go away. This is present bhajan status. So try to understand. Mahasangastu durlabo agamyo amaghasya. Mahapurush, a rare personality, exalted person, Guru Vaishnava pure. It's very rare, this kind of sangha. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, after searching so much country, continent, it's by chance I can meet with one brother. Amog means without any fail. Amog means inevitable. You can get result. There is no question, no doubt, nothing. Why? Because Bhagavan and his pure devotee non-different from each other. Devotee, Bhagavan, Bhagavat Tattva is all together. Dhamma, Nama, paraphernalia, all together is Bhagavat Tattva. Bhagavat Tattva doesn't mean Bhagavan alone, all Dham Tattva or everything you can throw. No, devotee you can throw. And Naraji Maharaj also giving formula, very nice formula, and going to indicate us. Tasmin tajjani bheda abhavat. If you know Sanskrit little bit, you can understand. Tasmin, I mean Bhagavan and his devotee, non-different from each other. Nandibai Indrasen, out of love, Bhagavan like to, you know, tasmin tajjane bheda abhavat. There is no difference. Tasmin tajjane bheda abhavat. Another formula I can say, Naradji Maharaj going to confirm, tadev saddhatam, two time. Prabhupada also speaking in his advice. So Naradji Maharaj speaking in formula, ordinary people cannot know, what is this man? Tadeva saddhatam. What do you mean? Tadeva saddhatam, tadeva saddhatam. Double time, same thing. Tadeva saddhatam, tadeva saddhatam. What do you mean? I cannot understand. How you can understand? Naraji Maharaj going to give advice, to us. Well, this kind of sadhu sangha you must do. Tadeva shaddhatam, you must serve him. You must serve him, tadeva shaddhatam, that is called actual bhajan. If you can stay with Guru Vaishnava, you can get all facility. Facility means not material facility. You can have the chance to hear Harikatha, Kirtan, Mahaprasad, also Sela Sridhar Goswami writing. Gradation of prasadam. Foolish people, they don't understand. Sridhar Goswami is speaking, the source from where Mahaprasad coming, who is arranging? If he is Madhupramija Madhav Goswami Maharaj, if the prasadam is arranged by Srila Bhakti Pramapuri Goswami Maharaj, then be sure 100% it is prasadam. Or any mediocre bhakta or kanishta bhakta. So who is going to arrange prasadam according to that and degree, according your kripa can vary. You never think before this thing. Also, I already gave answer about Mahaprasadam. So many questions coming. They are also now leaving me and gone away to get more facility. I am very happy. Let them go away. I am less interested. If their luck is good, they can hear, otherwise they can go to hell or anywhere they like. Tadeva Shadvatam, Tadeva Shadvatam. By this word, Naraji Maharaj wanted to confirm that Sadhu Sangha is a must, Sadhu Sangha is a must. You must do Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Seva. Why? Satan prasangyat mama virja sangvido bhavanti hitkarna rasayana kataha tvayyoshanat asu apavargani shadhyarati bhakti anukramishati. Without a pure sadhu, nobody can inform you perfectly. Because everybody has some self-interest. If not self-interest, the smell of self-interest. If you can prove, if you can try to prove, no self-interest, Maharaj, but I can prove. Like mathematics, there is no self-interest, but there is a smell of self-interest. Smell of self-interest. So you will have to stay, you'll have to hear Prabhupada speaking, you have to attend. A pure sadhu has no smell of self-interest. Then you can understand what is Rasa Leela, what is Gopi Gita. Otherwise, like idiot, you can, you know, run around. Move around. Try to understand, I was speaking. Those who are pure devotee, I already told yesterday, you can remember, all Paramahansa Dharma, all coming from the source, Krishna Charan. The source of all Paramahansa Dharma resting unto the lotus feet of Krishna, whereas you are going to blame, we are going to find some fault with Krishna. Krishna is not authentic, his character is not good. If at all he is going to do this way, I can also do. Yesterday I told, na? Then you will have to Isvaranam vachaha satyam tathaiva charitam kachit. Maybe tomorrow also I can discuss. So try to understand. If those who are following Paramahansa Dharma, pure Guru Vishnu, if material karma not going to disturb them, then how you can expect Krishna, the source of all Paramahansa, can feel disturbance with association of Gopi and this, that? You think Gopi is all woman, very beautiful lady, you can enjoy, you think that way? All people, they have this conception. Gopi means is very nice lady, Krishna dancing. Guru Padma used to speak, my son, foolish people, they think it is ball dance. It is not ball dance of hotel. They are going to die. When they are going to violate the instruction of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Jiva Goswami Bhad, Rupa Goswami Bhad, they are going to follow one so-called guru who is going to, you know, change their decision, Siddhanta. They can go to hell together with guru. All the followers together, Gurudev, together with the followers, they are going to hell. In Shastra it is written. Those who are misguiding common people, in the name of Harivajan Harikatha, they are going to hell. So, a pseudo guru, so-called guru, is inevitably he is going to hell, with, together with a follower. So today, at present, ism, different kind of ism develop. But in bhajan, there should not be any ism. Prabhupada speaking, if I fix some siddhanta, it is siddhanta, it is not ism. Ism mean there can be some opposition. This ism, if I going to establish communism, then capitalism can come and fight with me. If I am going to support communism, then capitalism can surely come and throw me, bound, fight with me. Prabhupada speaking, no! Our Siddhanta is not like ism. Once Siddhanta spoken, is forever. You have no option to switch over to another Siddhanta Vichar. Siddhanta means fix up. And Siddhanta also, definition of Siddhanta is that it is the Vichar of Bhagavan. Try to understand, very secret Siddhanta. Siddhanta means, Siddhanta means which is approved by Bhagavan. That I am speaking, that is called Siddhanta. What I am speaking, out of my devotional attitude, if bhakti is not there, I cannot get support to speak out Harikatha. Surely, if there is no devotional activity inside me, if I am kapat, then surely I cannot get support to speak Harikatha. And Siddhanta cannot come inside my heart. I cannot speak. Siddhanta can come from transcendental world, whereas Ism can come this from this material world. Siddhanta coming from transcendental world, Siddhanta coming from the lotus mouth of pure Guru Vishnu, those who are busy with Seva, because Siddhanta and Seva are almost same. When you can find Siddhanta in applied form, it is called Seva. When you can philosophically know this is Seva, it is called Siddhanta. I mean the question of satisfaction. I mean the question of full satisfaction of Supreme Lord can come. Follow. So whereas I told you, the source of all paramahansa is resting on the lotus feet of Krishna, whereas we are going to blame Krishna, the Krishna is doing. Yesterday I told Parikshit Maharaj, if Parikshit Maharaj not going to express his doubt, how we could realize all material people could go against? At least some certain portion they are going to understand. Then obviously they are not going to whole and total, you know, whole world not going, some portion, majority of them they are going to fight. They cannot understand any Siddhanta Vichar. If Parikshit Maharaj is not at all going to put this question, it is good that Parikshit Maharaj, he is actually Esho Mahabhagavataha, great exalted devotee, who got darshan of Bhagavan in the womb. Itself in the womb of mother, he got the darshan. We can try to take darshan of lotus feet of Bhagavan after taking bath. But Sukadeva, Parikshit Maharaj already is sure, already got the chance to see Supreme Lord in the womb of mother. So lucky. So how we can say that Sukadeva Parikshit Maharaj is material? Parikshit Maharaj is Mahabhagavat. But still Parikshit Maharaj is going to put this question for us. If Parikshit Maharaj is not going to put this question, then we could not get the scope to discuss on this point, what is bhakti, what is prema, what is rasa, or follow what I say. So we have no scope. So Parikshit Maharaj putting question, Atmakam Jadipati hi Kritavan Vaijugupsitam. Surely Krishna, he is the Supreme Lord, he has done some mistakes of dirty things. Why? Paradara Abhimarshanam, wives of other people. It's very dirty. Yes. It's dirty in this material world. Because there is so many countless hero in this material world, it is very derogatory. Very hateful, we can hate, we can reject, because in material world there is countless hero and countless heroine. They are going to exchange love, bodily love, material love. Yesterday I told the explanation by Keshav Goswami Maharaj. Even mentally it is prohibited to think about Rasa Leela. So what to speak about physical association of Rasa Leela? More dangerous. Even mentally it is prohibited. Atmakam Jadipati hi Kritavan Vaijugupsitam. Surely he has done some mistake. Oh, so dirty thing he has done. Then Sukadeva Goswami is going to prove, not at all dirty thing. Not at all dirty thing. Don't think that way. So transcendental, so pure, so pure, so pure, even my tongue cannot speak. I am unable to speak. Yesterday I wanted to establish what Krishna speaking and what Krishna doing, there is no disparity. What Krishna doing, advising, and what Krishna doing, you can discover some disparity, but theoretically, but practically, in a scientific way, I can prove Krishna doing Rasa Leela, it is not for his, it is not his self-interest. It is not his self-interest, he is bound to do. It is his commitment. Je yathaman prapadyante tan sathaiva bhajamyaham. It is not material love. So that you can understand the thesis of Gopi Gita. Some idiot writing thesis on Gopi Gita. Whereas Sanatana Goswami is speaking, oh my God, we cannot understand anything. Only Krishna can understand the mood of gopis, gopikas, and those gopikas can understand the mood of Krishna. What they want to speak, what they are doing, why they are speaking, we don't know anything. We know nothing. Sanatana Goswami was speaking, I beg for pardon. Sanatana Goswami is speaking, I beg for pardon unto the lotus feet of those gopikas. They, out of their causeless mercy, please help me to understand the meaning of Gopi Gita. It's very, very rare, so complicated. Their loveful attitude is so complicated. Why Krishna doing this way? Why Gopika is doing? Why Lalita Vishakha doing? It is not a matter of joke. It is not a matter of joke that I can preach this thing all over the world. It is not a matter of joke. It is not a matter of joke. Don't think that. So anyway, Atmakam Jodhivatihi Kritavana Vijugup Sitam. Krishna surely has done. Yesterday I wanted to establish what Krishna doing. If at all Krishna doing Vastaharan Leela, you can go through Vastaharan Leela explanation done 2 years back. You can go all scientific description. You cannot develop karma, dirty thing inside heart. After hearing Vastaharan Leela, you can, with exclamation, you can, oh my God, I was so dirty, I was thinking that way. I couldn't understand, this is Vastaharan Leela. Yes. Yes. You are misguided. All the way you are misguided. All the way you are misguided. All the way you are misguided. You are not getting any indication of pure devotional practice, which is possible only by the help of Prabhupada, by the help of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, by the help of Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, by the help of Keshav Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Pumaturi. They are never going to make any compromise with negative world. They are not going to make any compromise with negative world. Even Srila Bhakti Pumaturi Goswami Maharaj going to speak in front of Narasimha Maharaj, who already leave body, that at present there is great danger. In our own sampradaya, some sahajiya going to preach in such a way, he can destroy the whole system of Raganuga Bhajan. Even Bhakti Pumaturi Goswami Maharaj speaking this way. So I wanted to establish yesterday, if Krishna doing Rasa Leela, if Krishna doing Vastaharan Leela, you will have to please, you will have to understand the gravity, the inner meaning. Why Krishna doing? Krishna is aptokam. Aptokam is self-saturated. Material people, they need some help of material object. Material people, they need some material object, a man or woman, to enjoy life. But those who are Paramahansa, you need not supply any outside object so that they can enjoy. Try to understand. You think you are getting enjoyment by Paramanna Rasagulla, sweet ball, and you are enjoying taking so many things and enjoying your, you know, association with woman devotees and this, that. Many times I told, you are saying, sister, ultimately I think she is your wife, not sister. But you are going to speak, oh, Bahin, sister, ultimately she become your wife. Oh, Mataji, then finally she become your Pitaji. Foolish, number one, all kapat. So, material people, they need some supply of object of enjoyment. Follow? Rich people, they cannot count their money. So amount of money, they are not going to use for actual preaching of Bhagavan. They are going to stop. They are going to spend their money so that that devotee is going to speak this way without any, they are going to stop. They will make all problems so that they cannot talk. This is a demonic character. Our Gaudiya society, one and a single. I don't believe any society. All Gaudiya community should be one under the head of the umbrella of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. I cannot approve your conception. Separate, you know, I am speaking Harikatha by the mercy of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda. It is not my capacity. You think I am your enemy. And you think I am making one separate group. But I am not making a group. In my group, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Prabhupada, all there. I am not going to make any separate group. If you all like to leave me, I have no objection. You can go away. Join another society. I have no objection. You can go. I am very happy. There's some garbage gone. So this way, be sure, material people, those who are traveling around with enjoying mood, they have no devotional mood. They want to get some supply, some object of enjoyment, then they can enjoy. But this is not the case with Paramahansa Guru Vaishnava. This is not the case with any Paramahansa Guru Vaishnava. Or this is surely not the case with Bhagavan Sri Krishna, who is Atmaram. You already know, Bhagavan is self-saturated. Only Bhagavan is playing, doing this Leela. Bhagavan declared already, I am doing this to satisfy my devotees, not for my personal interest. Not for my personal interest, I am doing this kind of Leela. You know, tat yat sutta tat para bhavet. Manushya sarir, the human body, you can see Krishna is material man, you can think. But Bhagavan speaking and Sukhdev Goswami speaking that Bhagavan coming here in this material world is Satchidanandamai Vigraha, Satchidananda Rupayo Vishatpatvadi Hepati Hetabe. This sloka we know. Bhagavan coming in this material world by the help of Yogamaya Samabritam. Even Bhagavan is there, Gauranga Mahaprabhu traveling around in Gauranga, Gaurdham, Navadiv, nobody can understand, is Bhagavan. Yogamaya Samabritam. Follow. And Bhagavan coming in this world to do some Leela, to support his devotees, so that they can get some benefit, and those for common people also, they can get the privilege to discuss and analytically understand the Leelas, and they can get inspiration to do the bhajan of Supreme Lord Bhagavan. Who so merciful? So merciful Bhagavan. Bhajate tadrishi kira jasrutta tatpara bhavet. Bhajate tadrishi kira jasrutta tatpara bhavet. Bhavet means vidilingo. Vidilingo, affirmative. If you are not going to get an inspiration, you are busy with asasanga, then you can get punishment. Annatha, otherwise you will have to get punishment. Guru Maharaj, Guru Padmasambhava used to explain this way. Baba, it is written affirmative. Affirmative. Bhagavan does this kind of Leela. Just you will have to hear from a pure devotees who has no self-interest, then surely you can get. If not, if you are busy with asasanga still today, then you are not going to get any green signal. You can get punishment. Jasrutta tatpara bhavet. Bhavet means it's a must. If not, then otherwise you have to get punishment. Now I like to point you out, because you are intelligent, you think, at least everybody thinking I am intelligent. I also confess that you are intelligent than me. I am the only foolish person, you know, foolish personality in the world. Foolish, number one. You are clever, very intelligent. But Bhaktivinoda was speaking, everybody think that they are intelligent. We also confess they are intelligent. But intelligent according to their own estimation. Not according to the estimation of Krishna. They are all intelligent, I know. But they are intelligent according to their own estimation. They are not intelligent according to the estimation and approval of Bhagavan, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu or Krishna, not. Otherwise, Bhagavan Krishna, why is speaking in Srimad Bhagavatam? Esha buddhimatam buddhi manisha cha manishinam jas satyam anrite neha martena apnati amritam. Bhagavan speaking in Srimad Bhagavaji Mahaparaya 11th canto, Uddhav. It is not Uddhav Sangat, it is the teachings of Krishna. Krishna giving teachings to Uddhav. Antim, the final advice of Krishna before leaving this world, material world. So, bhajate tadrisi kira jasurta tatpara bhavet. Everybody thinking I am intelligent, but practically we think they are foolish, number one. They think we are intelligent. Well, they are intelligent, but Prabhupada Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, they are intelligent according to their own estimation, but surely they are not intelligent according to the estimation of Bhagavan. Otherwise, why Bhagavan speaking in Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran, 11th canto? Esha buddhimatam buddhi manisha cha manishinam jashatram anrite neha martena apnati amritam. With this unstable body and surrounding situation also unstable, you are going to make 5 years plan. Oh, 5 years I can do this. After 5 years I can make another 5 years program. But no program can stand because life is unstable. Anytime we can die. So without making any program, you make one absolute program. It is my request to hear absolute Harikatha. Whole day and night. Only try to earn some money to support your, you know, living. And all the time you go on. That even with, you know, with some positive mode. That I am doing, I am bound to do it to support my living. But to do. From heart you should have connection with Guru, Vaishnava, Bhagavan all the 24 hours. Not that when you are going to bed, you can lose the connection with Guru Vaishnava. Not that you can lose your connection with Gurudev when you are going to bed. Follow what I say. All the time you'll have to get in connection with Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan. Not even fraction of second. Who can say when I can die? Who can say when I can? Maybe that fraction of second I am going to neglect my bhajan. Maybe I can die that. Who can say? There is no guarantee. So, I like to point out one very important thing, that Sukhdev Goswami taking birth, not like ordinary man, or not like ordinary baby. Sukhdev Goswami taking birth after 16 years. Sukhdev Goswami less interested to come out in this material world from the womb of mother. Sukhdev Goswami less interested. When Bhagavan requesting, please come out, no, Maya can touch me. Then Bhagavan Sri Krishna promise, I promise you, Maya cannot touch you, please you come out. For 16 years, you are there inside the womb of mother, it is very troubleful. It's not good. Then he is going to come out, but Bhagavan going to promise him, then Maya cannot touch anybody, it is impossible. But I promise you, for a fraction of second, Maya can touch and Maya can go away. In this material world, it is the rules. Anybody going to take birth in the material world, Maya can touch even for a fraction of second, can come. Without that, not possible. It is the rules. So anyway, Shukadev Goswami taking birth and speaking very nicely. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, oh, so nicely speaking, like a parrot. So, Vyasadevji Maharaj, you can keep the name of your son is Shuka. Is very sweetly speaking like parrot, Shukadeva. This way, Shukadev Goswami getting the name Shukadev by Krishna, approved by Krishna. Now point is that, by birth, Shukadev Goswami is Paramahansa. Try to understand. By birth, Shukadev Goswami is Paramahansa, 100%. Who is less interested about the material world? Nothing. Even not going to ask for any prasadam, anything, even not milk. If at all by the mercy of Bhagavan, going to get some milk, sometime getting, sometime not getting. Oh well, is very happy. Madhavendu Puripada also, not going to ask. Namanande, by the enjoyment of Harinama, is self-saturated. He is not going to ask any prasadam, milk, anything from anybody. And if somebody is going to supply some milk, then by chance some Brajavasi is always going to take and offer to Bhagavan and drinking. This is their Paramahansa status. Now my question in front of you, if Shukadev Goswami by birth is Paramahansa, I confirm, then how we can expect that this topmost Paramahansa who has the right in Bhagavatam, because about Bhagavatam we know, Srimad Bhagavatam Pramana Mamalam Prema Pumartha Mahan. Also we know, Srimad Bhagavatam Purana Tilakam Jat Vaishnavanam Dhanam. It is the only property of those pure devotees. You think it is your property. Some sannyasi, some acharya can think my property, because he like to make property by the help of Bhagavatam. They are going to utilize Bhagavatam in such a way so that they can get lot of money. They are businessmen. And in Shastra it is written, those who are going to utilize Srimad Bhagavatam this way for their personal benefit, surely 100% they can go to hell. So it is confirmed in Shastra, Srimad Bhagavatam Purana Tilakam Yad Vaishnavanam Dhanam. It is the only property of pure Paramahansa, because they are not going to misuse this Bhagavatam. They are Paramahansa, they have no jealousy, no fighting, nothing. And how you can expect that Shukadev Goswami, who is by birth is Paramahansa, topmost Paramahansa, how we can expect that Shukadev Goswami can discuss some dirty leela of Krishna, rasa leela? How we can expect, whereas by birth Shukadev Goswami is Paramahansa, he never like to get any association, he is less interested about this material world. Then how we can expect that Shukadev Goswami can discuss some dirty leela, very naked leela of Krishna in front of Parikshit Mahārāja, who is also Param, who is also Mahābhāgavata. This question you should think over and again inside your mind. After my speech is over, you can think over and again. One by one I am going to give some argument, I mean Siddhanta Vichar. You can tally with your mind. Really so. I like to discuss about Gopi Gita, but I beg for pardon, I cannot discuss, it is impossible. Like Sanatana Goswami, under the guidance of Sanatana Goswami, only I want to get the kippa of my previous Guru Bharga, like Nayanmani Manjari, like Kamal Manjari. I like to pray to them, their Gopikas, our Guru Bharga. That's why I have some positive, you know, hope that I somehow, by their mercy, if I can understand something, then I can represent. Don't, you know, think that I am going to discuss this Gopi Gita out of my false ego. It is impossible. I am a fallen soul. In 10th canto, before Rasi, in 10th canto, before starting Rasa Leela, Badarayani Uvacha, I mean Sukhdev Goswami speaking. To whom? Bale Maharaj in front of Parikshit Maharaj, and there was 88,000 of Mani Rishis, everybody. They are hearing. So how you can expect that this Sukhdev Goswami, who is by birth Paramahansa, who can take trouble to discuss this dirty Rasa Leela in front of 88,000 of Rishi Mani and in front of Parikshit Maharaj, who himself is Paramahansa, topmost Paramahansa, by birth. So this is the main question. Now, first of all, I like to discuss, not discuss actually, I like to point out, tomorrow I can discuss, today I can, time cannot permit, I think so, still I can try. In the beginning of this Rasa Leela in 10th canto, the first slok, I like to draw your attention to the first slok of Rasa Leela. What is there, Bhadranu Vachu? Bhagavano pita ratrihi saradat phulla mallikaha bikshorantam manas chakre yogamayam upasritaha. Try to understand. Bhagavan opi. Even Bhagavan. Bhagavan opi. Ta ratrihi saradat phulla mallikaha Bikhyo rantum manas chakre yoga maya mupasritaha. Follow. Each and every word, I like to draw your attention to each and every word spoken by Sri Sukadeva Goswami. Badrayani Vacha, Bhagavano pitaratrihi saradat pulla mallikaha bikhyo rantum manas chakre yoga maya mupasritaha. This slok has a so deep inner meaning, even in dream you cannot imagine. Whole Rasa Leela, the gravity, the excellency and the inner meaning of this Rasa Leela, all going to rest in this first sloka. But you ignore. You are so foolish, you're going to think, okay, nothing there. But the whole Rasa Leela, the gravity of Rasa Leela, the importance, the significance, the inner meaning, the total thing, resting in this first sloka. But we are so foolish and idiot. Idiot means foolish. Cannot understand. Sukhdev Goswami is so clever. Sukhdev Goswami started this sloka with Bhagavan, not with Krishna. Try to understand. Sukhdev Goswami could start Krishna ta ratrihi saradat phul. Not right. Krishna, he could start with Krishna, but not me. Because Parikshit Maharaj, Sukhdev Goswami Maharaj, so clever, so intelligent. He is thinking about the benefit of the whole human society of this world. Somebody can reserve the right of misunderstanding Krishna. They cannot understand. So Sukhdev Goswami wanted to start with this word Bhagavan. I mean, Sukhdev Goswami wanted to give some impression. First, oh man, don't misunderstand. Oh men, don't misunderstand, you have no scope. It's Bhagavan. Somebody can think, oh, Krishna is not Bhagavan. Krishna, no. Krishna, Narayan is Bhagavan. Even in South India, if today you go, you can find, Narayan is not going to birth anywhere. There is no topics of birth. And so Narayan is Bhagavan. Krishna taking birth. So how we can say Krishna is, even they don't understand the meaning of Gita. জন্ম কর্ম চ মে দিব্যম যো ব্যক্তি তত্তত ত্যক্তা দেহম পুনর্জন্মম নৈতি মামিতি সহর্জুন। জন্ম কর্ম চ মে দিব্যম যো ব্যক্তি তত্তত, নট থিওরিটিক্যালি, ইফ সামবডি ক্যান ফিল অল দ্য সিগনিফিকেন্ট অফ মাই বার্থ, আই এম টেকিং বার্থ and my karma, why I am doing this and that, people going to find some fault with me. Janma karma cha me dibyam, all my taking birth, all my activities, even rasa leela, bastara, anything, any leela. I am not going to speak this leela, that leela, even bala leela, all leela. Bhagavan doing in such a way, if somebody can misunderstand, can go to hell. That's why Prabhupada was very careful, even he was so strict that he used to stop his disciple to go through 10th canto. Prabhupada was so clever, Prabhupada was so, you know, alert. Prabhupada was so alert, I heard from Gurudev. Gurudev speaking, one day after 9th canto over, I started discussing 10th canto, because in Bagh Bajar Gauriya Math, that time there was no division. Gauriya Mission is Gauriya Math, all same. That time it was the seva of Guru Maharaj. He was Puranamananda Brahmachari. He was versed in Shastra. He was a writer, he was the editor. Oh, he was very exalted Vaishnava. So Prabhupada gave him order to discuss Bhagavad Katha, Chaitanya Chaitanya, everything. Guru Maharaj personally told me, one day after first canto up to ninth canto, I already discussed under the guidance of Prabhupada. I never wanted to cross Prabhupada. And after that, by the desire of some devotees, I started only the Bala Leela, only I started 10th canto. Then the information gone to Prabhupada, that's called Guru. Oh, disciple can do anything, only can give both to me. Our disciple can do anything, we should not be so strict. We are more liberal, idiot, foolish conception. Even in Niti Shastra it is prohibited. Niti Shastra, even what to speak about our Puran, everything, you know, Bhagavatam, Veda. Follow what I say. This kind of strictness is a symptom of an authentic Guru. If Gurudev went, okay, he can do, only he can give support to me. Gurudev ki jai ho, only this one, he will have to speak. Then you can get all prasadam, money for traveling in foreign country, even if you like to marry with some white girl, you can do it, all everything. I mean, they are flattering personality. They are being loyal. They know if I am not loyaling, nobody can stay with me. They can go live. I can supply some, you know, nice thing to them to keep my disciple all around. Otherwise, nobody can stay. But Prabhupada was not flattering personality. So strictness of Gurudev is the evidence of his authenticity. Don't think otherwise. If Gurudev not going to speak strict, who can speak? We leave our father, mother all gone. Then who can? Prabhupada can regulate us. Bhaktivinoda Thakur can regulate us. Or our Guru Varga can regulate us. We want to be controlled. We want to be controlled by Guru Vishnu. That is our devotional practice. Nothing else. We don't like to something new. We never like to exhibit something new. Traditionally, Guru Parampara, I like to follow my Guru Parampara. So you can come to me or you can go away from me. I don't bother. I don't care. So, Prabhupada was so strict, Guru Maharaj speaking, that I know. That's why I never wanted to touch the vital chapters of Dasam Skandha. Only Bala Leela I started. Prabhupada was so strict. Oh, Paramananda already started, you know, 10th canto. Oh, then immediately Guru Maharaj stopped discussing. Paramananda already started discussing 10th canto. How dare to teach us? Not that they are fallen soul, to teach us. One time, Srila Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj was a nice preacher. Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj is aged than Prabhupada. Aged. He was aged than Prabhupada. So Prabhupada used to love him, respect him very much. And he used to love Gurudev very much. One day, Prabhupada giving some instruction to the library man, that today I request Bharati Maharaj, Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj to discuss some Harikatha in some place. He will have to go. Well, Bharati Maharaj coming in the noon time, 2 o'clock, taking one book, and after that gone for preaching. Prabhupada entering the library, 3 o'clock or 3:30, I cannot remember. Guru Maharaj speaking. Prabhupada asking to the library man, hey, already Bharati Maharaj gone for preaching? Yes, gone. Which book he took with him for preaching? He took actually Bhagavatam. Prabhupada speaking, our topics of preaching is the Kripa of Gauranga. We know Bhagavatam is same, but still, our procedure of preaching is to take the help of the mercy of Gauranga. Why not he is going to take Chaitanya Bhagavat? He is going to take Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran? Oh my God! Guru Maharaj speaking this way, Guru Padma speaking this way, Prabhupada always used to teach us how very serious, how deep meaning of Bhagavatam. Now everything cheap. Oh, I can also discuss. I am also a proficient lecturer. I can give lecture to you. You like to hear? I can give nice lecture. So here, actually, Sukadeva Goswami is so clever. Sukadeva Goswami thinking that if I start with Krishna, those who have some allergy with Krishna, they can react, they can say, oh, Krishna always doing this. So Sukadeva Goswami wanted to start with this comment, Bhagavan opita ratrihi saradat phulla mallikaha bikshorantam manas chakre yoga mayam upasritaha. Bhagavan opi. I mean, Sukadeva Goswami wanted to warn us, give us warning. I mean, Sukadeva Goswami wanted to give us warning. Be careful! You are going to think about Bhagavan. Who is Bhagavan? What is the definition of Bhagavan? What is the definition of Bhagavan? Aisharjasya samagyasya vidyasya yashasya sriyo gyano vairagyasya iva sharo iti bhago ingana. All complete power, all complete flame, all complete beauty, all complete. Complete mean, I already in the starting I told, complete mean whatever amount of pratishtha and glories you can take away from Krishna, infinity pratishtha can decorate the lotus feet of Krishna. Follow. Kamsa wanted to destroy Krishna. Shishupal wanted to destroy Krishna. Jarasandha wanted to destroy Krishna. Ravan wanted to destroy Ramchandra. So what? Try to understand. Any amount of appliances, if you take away, take off from Krishna, infinity treasure, infinity property, infinity appliances is decorating the lotus feet of Krishna. You can take infinity property. Infinity minus infinity is infinity. Infinity plus infinity. With this conception, you must apply this conception here. Follow what I say. Bhagavan, who is decorated with six opulences in complete form, complete money, never going to finish, infinity. That Bhagavan, Bhagavan OP, is Bhagavan. Still, he is going to do this Rasa Leela. Taratrihi, those night times, because that was not one night. Brahmaratra Upavitre, Brahmaratra Upavitre. After Brahmaratri gone, when Rasa Leela was finished, then Gopikas very so quickly, within fraction of second, finish Rasa Leela. Oh my God! Try to understand. Try to understand the gravity of this Rasa Leela, so that I can at all touch the significant, the discussion of, you know, Gopi Gita. It's called background. Without background, you would be in confusion. Follow? So Bhagavan OP, with this Bhagavan, this word, Shukadeva Goswami wanted to check us. Shukadeva Goswami wanted to check us, our wrong conception. And speaking, Bhagavan OPI TARATRIHI SHARADAT PULLAMALLIKAHA BIKSHORANTUM MANAS CHAKRE YOGU MAYAM UPASRITAHA. First point, Bhagavan. Second point, Taratri, means total Brahmaratri. One ordinary human being cannot dance even for 2 hours. Whereas we know Bhakreshwar Pandit, he is the eternal parsad of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. He used to dance 72 hours continuously. 72 hours continuously, non-stop dancing. Even in dream, you cannot do anything. You cannot take prasadam, you cannot wash your plate, you cannot wash your cloth. You are not going to wash my cloth. Even your body, you cannot take care. So much weak you are. And this, you know, Bhakreshwar Pandit, he used to dance continuously, non-stop, 72 hours. No urine, no drinking of water, no prasadam, nothing. Non-stop. Even in dream, you cannot believe. Even in dream, you cannot believe. I know. But this is fact. You believe or don't believe, that matters little. I am not interested with your belief and disbelief. You can disbelieve Prabhupada and throw. You can catch another Prabhupada. What I can do? You are liberty. You can do whatever you like. So, Bhikkhu Rantum Manas Chakre. Bhagavan took decision. And here also deep philosophy I can discuss tomorrow, not today. It will take time. Are Yoga Mayam Upasritaha is very vital point. Bhagavan, when going to do any Leela, going to take help of Yoga Maya Upasrita, not Mahamaya. So that contamination can be there. Try to understand. Try to rectify your conception. Try to rectify your wrong conception. Manas Chakre Yoga Maya Upasritaha. Simply you are going to misunderstand Krishna dancing with Gopikas. But you don't understand who is dancing, how dancing, why dancing. You are not interested. Oh, he is dancing. I can also dance in Saturday class, a Sunday club. Foolish, idiot. Whenever any action by any man is there, you'll have to go in details. What he is doing, how he is doing, what for all you will have to. Like I say, Gurudev is taking prasadam. Then you can have some conception. Okay, Gurudev taking prasadam, rice, jal, sabji. When I am speaking, a Gomata taking something, he is eating. Also, I am Gurudev eating. And Gomata eating. The conception, literal conception is same. He is a Gomata, she is eating and Gurudev eating. When I say a elephant going to take, so conception vary. When the eating of Gurudev or Bhaman Goswami Maharaj, then we know very little prasadam, very a little prasadam they are taking. Very, even a boy can take more than that. Gurudev we have seen. Continuously last, you know, 5 hours, 6 hours we have seen, Gurudev taking only boiled apple or some, you know, papita. No, not taking any rice, and previously used to take something, sweet rice, something. This is prasadam. So the conception, only by hearing eating, you cannot have flat conception. Only by hearing this term from me, oh, eating. Only by hearing this conception, eating, you cannot have any flat conception. You cannot make any confusion. The conception of Gurudev eating, the conception of Gomata eating, conception of lion eating, tiger eating, conception of elephant eating, all varies. An ant going to take some, one piece of sugar, one piece of very small piece of sugar. So many ant together, they are putting their effort to take, draw, to pull that piece of, you know, that sweet, you know, sugar particle into their room. Room, you know, all they are trying, all together. Oh, push, hey yo, they are pulling all together. And after that, they can take the taste of that sugar particle for a long time. Whereas if I give to you some amount of sugar, you can put in your mind and take immediately. Follow. And drink water. Whereas that amount of sugar, if I am going to put on an ant can die. So comparative statement, I mean the relative conception, should come first. If this relative conception not going to stand inside your heart, you can make confusion. Oh, Krishna dancing. That means same dancing like ball dance. Guru Maharaj used to say, it is not ball dance in the hotel, Saturday club, idiot. It is not ball dance. That everybody, all his wife going to dance with that chap, his wife going to dance with that chap, it is called civilized society. Also, they are going to arrange, you know, their food system. And at present we hear fast fooding. No time, they can take. Like dog and elephant, they take immediately, like jackal. And also they arrange, then no need of serving man. All, you know, food can be there in a big table. Everybody can dance and drink. And whenever they like, they can come like dog. They can take some in their plate and go away. No uchista, nothing. Very nice. We are liberal. We are more liberal. Eh? We are more liberal. Who is Prabhupada? Bhakti Siddhanta is very strict. Oh no, at present you cannot. Some acharya, some, you know, some devotees, sannyas speaking. At present, they are speaking. At present, if we are going to follow Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, then we cannot run Gauriya Math. They are speaking. Whereas Guru Padmasambhava is speaking, without following Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, we cannot run Gauriya Math. So opposite conception. Disciple of Gurudev, speaking total wrong conception. Without, you know, when we follow Prabhupada and Bhakti Vinod Thakur, we surely cannot run Gauriya Math. You don't know what is Gauriya Math. You are not inside Gauriya Math. Better you can go away to home and marry. It's more good. This kind of wrong conception can break the whole system of our bhajan. We cannot allow. We can protest. Guru Padmasambhava used to say, well, if we are not going to follow Prabhupada and Bhakti Vinod Thakur by the instruction of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, by the instruction of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada, only and only by the instruction and principle, idealism of Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, we can run Gauriya Math. Otherwise, it is hotel. It is not any math. You can get salary, you can sell something, you can buy something, you can eat. And you are at privilege. Follow what I say. This way, wrong conception. So, you must be very careful about this point. The conception of eating should not be flat, and should not be, you know, same. So there should be some relative conception that an ant going to eat something, oh, this much. When one tiger going to eat, have some conception. When a lion going to eat, when a jackal, when a camel going to eat, different conception can help us to grow the philosophy. Now when Krishna dancing, by hearing this, only this word, Krishna dancing with woman, you are going to pass bad remark. Oh, he's doing this. Oh, it must be like this. So Bhagavan Opita Ratrihi Saradat Pulla Mallika Bhiksho Rantum Manaschakre Yogamaya Mupasritaha. By the help of Yogamaya, Bhagavan going to manifest transcendental of Prakita Satchidananda Vigraha. Bhagavan going to express his mood of Leela. Bhagavan took decision to Leela to do this kind of Leela. Narottama Thakur, our previous Guru Varga, Rupanuga Guru Varga, Narottama Thakur praying, try to understand. Narottama Thakur praying unto the lotus feet of Narottama Thakur praying unto the lotus feet of Bhagavan. You know the Kirtan, na? Kabe ham bujabo jugala priti. Follow. When I can understand the secrecy of the love affair between Radha and Krishna. Narottama Thakur praying. If it is material, if it is dirty, why should Narottama Thakur take trouble to write Kirtan? Follow what I say. So Narottama Thakur praying from heart. Ar kabe nitai chander koruna hoibe, samsar basona mor kabe tuchcha hobe. Follow. Bishoy chhariya kabe shuddho hobe mon, kabe ham herabo sri Vrindavan. Narottama Thakur speaking, I have not seen Vrindavan. You not seen? You been there. You went there in Vrindavan, you stayed there for a long time with Jiva Goswami Pad and everything. No, I never saw Vrindavan. When I can saw? Ar kabhi hirabo si Vrindavan. They are so humble, so perfect. They are going to teach us. Physically, if you go to Vrindavan, it is not going to Vrindavan. If you can go from heart to Vrindavan, going to touch the mellow of Radha Krishna Prema Vilas, then you can feel something. Narottama Thakur, his prayer, Parthana Prem Bhakti Chandika. All, it is my request to everybody. That you must go through Prem Bhakti Chandika, Parthana Prem Bhakti. Srila Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj, my Gurudev, Siksha Guru, he used to discuss all Kirtan analytically. He couldn't get scope, very early he gone from this material world. We never expected. Anyway, what to do? They are going to cheat us and go away because they find we are just, you know, cheater. That's why they like to leave us and go away. So Narottama Thakur speaking, Ar kabe nitai chader koruna haibe. Narottama Thakur speaking, আর কবে নিতাই চাঁদের করুণা হইবে, সংসার বাসনা মার কবে তুচ্ছ হবে, বিষয় ছাড়িয়া কবে শুদ্ধ হবে মন, কবে হাম হেরব শ্রী বৃন্দাবন, রূপ সনাতন পদে হইবে আগতি, কবে হাম বুঝব যুগল পিরতি। ফলো, when I can understand the love affair between Radha and Krishna, when I can get the kippa of Sanatana and Rup, when I can get the kippa of Sanatana and Rup Goswami, so that I can understand the secrecy of this love affair between Radha and Govinda, which is obviously, which is surely not material karma. Try to throw away this conception. Try to throw away this material conception from your heart and mind. Go and throw first, then come to me. Then I can take trouble to discuss something which I learned from Guru Bhargava. So, Vikriritam Brajavadu Viridancha Vishnu, it is written, there also, this is the last slok. First slok I speak, the last slok of Rasalila, Panchadhyayi, fifth chapter, I can touch, and today I can stop. This is the last. To give you a clear conception about the secrecy, about the gravity of this excellency of this secret Tattva Vigyan. First slok I started where I recite, you know already, Bhagavano Pitaratrihi Saradot Pulla Mallikaha Bhikshorantum Manas Chakri Yoga Mayam Upasrita. This is gone first. And now I am going to speak the last sloka of Panchadhyayi. What is that? Bhikriditam Brajabad Viridancha Vishnu Saddhanitam Manas Sranimad Athabarna Yajja Bhaktim Param Bhagavatim Patilabhya Kamam Ridrogamasupahinati Achirena Dhira Achirena Dhira. If you discuss those two slokas, only the starting sloka and the ending sloka, I can open the chamber, the secret chamber, I can show, oh my God, this is our wrong conception. So nice. Vikriditam Brajavad Viridancha Vishnu. Here also, finishing touch. Here also, Sukhdev Goswami, a so fine art, is going to touch with this word Vishnu. Again, Sukhdev Goswami wanted to rectify your wrong conception. Sukhdev Goswami could see. Sukhdev Goswami could speak Krishna, but not speaking. Vishnu. Vishnu and Krishna. Krishna is the word which can give us the conception of mellow, rasa, and very sweet. And Vishnu is concept, oh, all-pervading Lord, oh, so all-pervading Lord, oh, Vishnu. So, Sukhdev Goswami is so clever. Sukhdev Goswami is so clever, he wanted to draw our attention, be careful, he's Vishnu. Is Vishnu try to sarvo bhuteshu vishati iti Vishnu. All corner, all point, everywhere, infinity world. All pervading Lord mean Bhagavan is present everywhere, even in the dust particle. It is called the conception of Vishnu. With Krishna we are playing, we love Krishna. If we have this kind of, you know, if we have this kind of, you know, Siddhanta Vichar, Krishna is Supreme Lord, is a great, is all, then we cannot get the enjoyment of Rasa Leela or Bala Leela, all is we can get. That's why in Chaitanya Charitamrita it is written, Oishajya Ganate Sithil Oishajya Sithil Preme Nahim Arprito. Bhagavan speaking, Bhagavan Krishna speaking, and the conception, I mean, Sukadev Goswami, I mean, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami writing. Actually, it is a conception of Krishna. But Sukadev Goswami is going to show us how Krishna speaking. Krishna speaking, Aishwarya Sithil Premena Himar Pritho. If opulences, if this conception of, if this, If this conception of affluence is coming to contaminate, then I cannot feel my love, my love become very liquid. Shithil. A strong binding is Krishna is my Krishna. I can beat Krishna. I can play with Krishna. Who is Krishna? This conception Krishna like. Krishna like to hear, my Guru Maharaj many times used to say, when Krishna playing with coward boys, friends, those boys, Shidam, Sudam, Vasudha, hey, who is Krishna? Hey, who are you? Hey? You're speaking. Very nice conception. Who are you? A friend, can fight, can ride, the soldier of Krishna. Hey, you are defeated. You have to take me, our soldier. Guru Maharaj used to speak and laugh. This is the conception of Krishna Prema. Dry conception cannot help you to get entry into Krishna Leela, secret Krishna Leela. Surely not. So this conception you should remember from Krishna, from Chaitanya Charitamrita, our Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking, Aisharya Shithil Premi. If there is a conception of Aisharya, appliances, then the love affair between me and you, Krishna speaking, become very diluted, very, very liquid. Binding force should be very strong. Like you can put one stick inside water. You can put one stick inside honey. You can put stick inside semi-liquid. Or you can put a stick inside wax. Wax, you know? Wax. One slab of wax, you can put one stick inside. But if I request you, can you put this stick inside an iron bar? Can you put your stick inside iron bar? Bale, Maharaj, not possible. Why? Because intermolecular attraction of each two iron molecule is inconceivable. You cannot. Their binding force is so strong, you cannot externally find any molecular space. Externally you cannot find any molecular. There is no space. How can? But inside mercury you can put. Because mercury is similar, you can put. This way, when there is strong bondage between Krishna and me, our love affair is beyond any material conception. If this be the case, in that case material conception, appliances cannot dilute our love relation. Follow what I say. When the love relation between me and Krishna is so strong, anything you can do, but you cannot break our relationship. Impossible. Tight relation, so strong relationship between Krishna and me. Then in that case, anyhow you can try your best to dilute our relationship, but you can come out failure. Because our relationship is strong relationship, it cannot break. Guru Padmini used to speak, those Brajavasis, Guru Padmini used to speak that Brajavasis, those who are Brajavasis, they have their spontaneous love. They have spontaneous loveful relation with Krishna. Guru Padmini used to speak from Chaitanya Charitamrita that those Brajavasis, they have their spontaneous, natural love affair with Krishna. Their relationship is so strong. And also Krishna have his strong love for Brajavasis. Those Brajavasis, they have strong love for Krishna, and those Krishna also have strong love for Brajavasis. In Bengali it is written, Brajavasi Shavabiki Piti Krishna Prati. Brajavasi Shavabiki Piti, natural. quite natural, not artificial. But you want to develop some artificial relationship with me. I like to reject. Guru Padma Yuti is written in Chaitanya Chaitamrita that Brajavasi Sabhavikipiti, natural love, spontaneous. Brajavasi Sabhavikipiti Krishnapati and Krishna also having natural love appear, spontaneous love. It is eternally present. Actually, if you can discover someday, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, someday if you can discover this point, what I am speaking today, someday, luckily, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, if you can discover this point, that you have your eternal relationship with Krishna, but you forget. I have my eternal relationship with Krishna. I forget. You forget. Everybody forget. So I have to remember. That is called bhajan. We have to install this kind of relationship. Install means it is already there. Install doesn't mean you have to bring from outside. It is naturally present inside jivatma. But only you will have to discover. Only you will have to discover this and bring into focus. Then you can enjoy. The day you can realize what is actual bhajan, I promise you, you cannot leave Krishna bhajan. If somebody is going to kill you, you cannot leave Krishna bhajan. So loveful relation with Krishna, so loveful relation, boundless, endless love of Krishna for us. But we will have to discover our endless love for Krishna, then our Rupanuga Bhajan, Raganuga Bhajan, Gopiketa discussion of Bastara Lila, Bastaran Lila, all can come out successful, successful, successful. Be careful. Don't be foolish. Common people speaking something, you are going to lose your track, you are going to follow. So, try to remember. Akamo, sarvakamo, ba mokshakamo, udarudhi, tibrena bhakti yogena jajeto purushamparam. It's a must. If you have some kama inside your heart, no matter. If you have 50% kama, 50% off, gone, okay. 90% gone, 99% gone, still try to, still, it is my advice, it is the advice of Shastra, Bhagavatam, you will have to worship Krishna. You will have to keep relationship with Krishna Bhakta and Krishna. Akama sarva kama vaha moksha kama udarudhi tivrena bhakti yogena jajeta purusham param vanchakalpata rusa ke basindu vyavacha patitanang pavana bhavishna bhyo namo namo.